You know what a track is? Evidence you're not alone out there. Humbling, eh? Thank you. Kia ora. It's been a while. You enjoying yourself out in the bush? There's nothing I love more than strapping a pack on and getting lost out there. So I'm glad you've had the chance to wind down and take it in after all that excitement earlier. Got a couple of updates for you. First and foremost, we released the promo film a few days ago. It's been wild. Phones ringing off the hook kind of wild. In fact, we're almost fully booked for the autumn season already. I should be celebrating, but I've been sitting in my office, laser focused on how to keep day tripper numbers down. We're not legally allowed to charge an entry fee, and quotas are hard to enforce, so maybe the solution is an outreach. Give those snot-nosed students a taste of the work we do here. Who knows? Might even make conservationists out of some of them. Anyway, the film's up, but we're still working on some final touches to the website. Oh, and the marketing team had a request. There's an old lighthouse by the coast that they'd like a few shots of. Can you head over there and I'll fill you in on everything else that's been happening? So, the bloke with the antlers. The firm we hired to do the promo film has gotten in touch with one of the big online networks, and they're up for the idea of turning your moose chase into a documentary. I'm still working on my book, but I'm thinking this could be a good accompaniment. You've seen the show, now get the details straight from the moose's mouth. Oh, of course, they want to use your footage, and maybe even get an interview. You keen? Give it a think. Good opportunity to raise your profile, though I get the feeling that's not something that matters all that much to you. That's why I like you, Ehor. What you see is what you get. In other news, Josh convinced me to let him go to that advanced screening of Resplendent Sword. He loved it, the brat, but then he must have read the book's cover to cover about 10 times. He said, get this. He said that it had a strong message about environmentalism and cooperation. You think the same people who left all those messes behind came up with that? Hypocritical rubbish. It has given him a newfound appreciation for the reserve, though. He's even expressed an interest in hunting for the first time in his entire life. I think it's as much your influence as anything, but he's not going to admit to that anytime soon. people I wouldn't have expected it from. It's been humbling. Here's a good spot. I'm not going to go out of my way to drop in on the town, especially now I'm so busy with the book, but it is nice to feel like you're part of a community again. Moody, let's get one a little closer up too. This beach is where I saw that moose cow about 35 years ago. She was staring out at the sea, looked heaps lonely. It probably won't surprise you to learn that I was kind of a weird kid, introverted and a bit in my own world. There was something about her that connected with me then, and still does. No one's manned this place for decades. Bolted shut. Perfect. I'll send these on right away. Right, let's grab a close-up from around here. It's been quite the adventure we've embarked on, eh? I can finally see a future for this place where we're not at the mercy of outside actors, and that's in no small part thanks to you. To preserve Te Awaroa's heritage and safeguard our unique biodiversity requires constant vigilance, but I think I'm up for the challenge. Wouldn't you agree, Eho? Thank you.